The Villanova Wildcats are the national champions in men's college basketball for the second time in 3 years. It was a topsy-turvy tournament filled with upsets and last-second drama, but the number one seed out of the Big East was immune to the chaos and the close calls. Villanova won all six of its games by at least a 12-point margin, including a 79-62 cruise control victory over Michigan in the title game. It goes without saying that the Wildcats were the biggest winners of this big dance, but they weren't the only ones, nor were the Michigan Wolverines the only losers. The one shining moment montage was a nice walk down memory lane of the past 3 weeks, but that only scraped the surface of everything that transpired in this edition of March Madness. Here's the full list of the biggest winners and losers from the 2018 men's NCAA tournament. Loyola Chicago's run was an unbelievable story, but we've seen number 11 seeds reach the Final Four before. In due time, the Ramblers will be interchangeable with 2006 George Mason and 2011 VCU on the list of the unlikeliest national semifinalists. But a number 16 seed beating a number 1 seed? That's what the 2018 NCAA tournament will always be remembered for. UMBC didn't just beat number 1 overall seed Virginia, either. The Retrievers made history by stomping the heavily favored Cavaliers. No team this season had scored more than 68 points against Tony Bennett's vaunted packline defense, but UMBC scored 53 just in the second half of the 74-54 beatdown. J. Iris Lyles battled through leg cramps for most of the second half to finish with 28 points on a scant 11 field goal attempts. As a team, the Retrievers, who mustered up a mere 39 points in a blowout loss to Albany in late January, shot 54.2% from the field and 12 of 24, 50%, from three-point range. A number 16 seed was bound to win one sooner or later, but that inevitability didn't make UMBC's victory any less mind-blowing. Generally speaking, using NCAA tournament results to make overarching statements about the strength or weakness of a conference is a silly exercise. People who don't like a certain conference, usually the ACC or Big 12, since those have been the top leagues for the past few years, will point to the league's .500 or worse record after the first weekend and say, "See, they aren't that good." It's dumb to disregard hundreds of regular season games and instead focus on a couple of results in an unpredictable tournament, but what are sports without hot takes? That said, the Pac-12 was clearly the worst power conference during the regular season, and it didn't do much to refute that stance by getting completely eliminated from the tournament by the end of the first full day. Only three Pac-12 teams received an invitation to the big dance. Arizona was a number 4 seed and a strong candidate to win the title. UCLA and Arizona State were sent to Dayton for first 4 games. Both the Bruins and the Sun Devils were downright dreadful in their immediate exits. UCLA scored just 58 points against St. Bonaventure, but that's better than Arizona State's 56 points against Syracuse. As a result of those duds, the Pac-12 only had one team in the round of 64. Buffalo promptly blew out Arizona 89-68, ensuring that many brackets across the nation were busted about 12 hours after the first round began. To make matters worse, both the West Coast Conference, Gonzaga, and Mountain West Conference, Nevada, reached the Sweet 16. So those leagues have temporary bragging rights over the Pac-12 as the best of the West.